Hello everybody and welcome back to the Let's Play the Railroad Tycoon 3 campaign. And today we're doing the Orient Express on hard difficulty. Now first things first. First of all, I'm talking quietly because it's late and I don't want to wake people up. And secondly, I apologise for not uploading any videos in the last month. The reason being is that I've been busy with university exams, which have now ended, thankfully. Which means that I can carry on with these videos and recording and having fun like I do. Anyway, this is the Orient Express scenario, and again, I'm playing on hard. This is probably the hardest scenario in the campaign, in the game. And realistically, I found two ways you can go about it. One means getting a gold is easier, not easy, but easier. And the second one is you'll probably end up with a silver, not gold. So the Orient Express is a luxury express train that goes all over Europe, like Paris, Venice, Berlin, possibly even Moscow, but what we're interested in is the Vienna to Istanbul route. Now, it's 1880 and we've got until 1914. Actually, that's interesting. I thought this map started in 1888. Apparently it starts in 1880. Could be the 1.05 patch fixing that. As opposed to the default game. But it means that we have 35 years. Because it's inclusive of, I think, the year 1914. I can't be sure. But anyway, we've got a lot of time. The problem is at the time, so 1880 to 1914, you've got a lot of countries. You've got the Austro-Hungarian Empire, which is the largest country in the map. But you've also got Serbia, Bulgaria, Montenegro, Russian Empire under the Tsar. I might have said Romania and the Ottoman Empire. So yeah, a lot of countries, a lot of boundaries to cross, and also it's just a long way and the terrain's not very nice, and this map, it's very difficult to make money, to be honest, which is why, as boring as it may be, I'm actually going to go with the unconventional routes, which is industry. It's kind of cheating because it means that I'm not really going to run a railroad until very late on, and you'll see why when you read the gold objectives. So yeah, that initial description kind of says everything that I've kind of already told you. Orient Express was, and kind of still is, the epitome of luxury travel by land. The line pull was not as much used as it was, but there is something called the Oriental Express, which I think goes from Beijing to Singapore, or Beijing to Bangkok, or Southeast Asia. And that's called the Oriental Express. The line pulled wagons lit sleeper. I think that's a manufacturer like Pullman of coaches. Featured gourmet meals and plush sleeping accommodations. The most difficult feat was arranging for passage for cars through several nations and differing track specifications. Yeah, basically building it. And getting through all the boundaries and whatnot. It's your task to make this difficult route profitable and a shining example of engineering. So for bronze, we have to connect Vienna to Istanbul before 1914. So Vienna is here, Istanbul is here, so literally right across the map. Silver, we've got to do that and have an express average lifetime express speed of 20 miles an hour or higher. That in itself, not too difficult. Gold, we've got to have average express speed of 30 miles an hour and a personal net worth of $15 million. Now, as we all know, I'm not great with personal net worth, so I'm going to be careful. Social conditions, none. We do have AI, which means that we can buy out AI, we can buy stock, we can issue bonds, we can issue stock, we can declare bankruptcy, we can buy people out, we can do whatever. We can build an unconnected track. We can also start more than one company, not that we're going to. Anyway. So let's start our company, and obviously it's the Orient Express, so we are Orient Express. But not the Orient Express that you might think, because we're not going to be a railroad, we are going to be industry. Interestingly, unique to this scenario, is at the start we have a selection. Now, if you've not done this map before, you might think, it's not that big of a deal. It is, because each one gives you a bonus. And these bonuses are very, very useful, depending on what kind of game you want to play. So, for example, science and technology, I think, increases like possibly reliability of trains, top speed of trains, maybe like hauling power. Might make trains cheaper to buy, but that might be business and finance. It might also reduce interest rates and on bonds, and maybe make like overheads and stuff cheaper. Industry and construction. I think construction is just literally cheaper track, maybe also cheaper trains. But we are going to go for industry and construction, because industry, very useful. Admittedly, politics is also very useful, because if you select politics, you get access rights for, I think, 75% cheaper. Certainly very... Yeah, 75% cheaper. And access rights in this game do cost a lot. I mean, I think to get into the Ottoman Empire alone is... Yeah, there you go, 5 million. So that reduces down to 1.25 million. So he saves himself 3.75 million. Now the route we're going to take, eventually, we're not going to build any track yet, will involve going through Romania, Bulgaria, and Ottoman Empire, maybe Serbia, and maybe Russia, which only actually costs 100,000. But Bulgaria and Romania, well, would help if I highlighted them at the correct time. Romania and Bulgaria are 1 and 3 million each, and then you've got 5 million. So overall, we're going to need 9 million without discount, which we're not going to get because we selected industry. But we don't get the bonus just yet. What industry does is, I think it means that you can buy industries for 30% cheaper. But we're not going to do anything just yet because we're waiting for that bonus to come in. So we've got industry or construction. We're going to go for industry. So we have a net worth at the moment of 100,000, as do the two AI. Now, all things industrial are your domain, or so it would seem. The contacts you've cultivated over the years have given you the ability to lower the building and purchasing cost of industries by 30%. So to buy pre-existing and to build our new industries is 70% the price of what it would be. Why did you want to build railways again? We don't. That's the thing. Because, for some weird reason, be it the terrain or just the economy, it's very hard to make a profitable railway in this map. So, pause the game. We do have until 1914, so we've got a ton of time. Yeah, we've got 34 years, I think. Because we don't have the year 1914, but we do have the year 1880, so that's 34 years. So, first things first, let's look for industries. Now, we do have access to Austria-Hungary, we don't have access to anywhere else, not that we're going to buy anywhere else. So, grain. There's a fair amount, but not a whole lot. Logs, some over here, but that's in Romania. Also, that is in Austria-Hungary. Just got to be wary, because that's Serbia, which we don't have access rights to. Interestingly, the AI have set themselves up. There's going to be town names that I can't pronounce, but that's Zagreb and Varaždin. Zagreb, of course, being the capital of Croatia. No idea how you pronounce that name. Not even going to try. For anyone who's seen my Russian game, they know my pronunciation of town names is probably not great. And all these, dare I say, Slavic? Eastern European town names, not going to go well. Admittedly, that's Hungary, not part of Yugoslavia, so I don't know if it's Slavic or not. Anyway, that's aside. Ooh, lots of produce, so we could build a distillery. We could just buy farms, to be honest. Because now that things are cheaper, we could easily build a distillery in Zombethli, I don't know how you pronounce that. Or we could just build it in the middle of nowhere. Literally in the middle of the things. We're gonna go for that. So, let's go. There is a pre-existing brewery in Gior, and a furniture factory has appeared for the first time near Bucharest. That's the capital of Romania, so we don't have access to there. Is there any lumber? Well, there's a fair amount here, but it's not really being supplied by the logs. And the dairy processor has appeared for the first time near... Not going to pronounce that name. Guess that'd be like Zeged? Zeged? No, it wouldn't be Zeged, would it? Zeged? Yeah, something like that, I don't know. Zeged. Anyway. So, we are making a profit. Which is good. As I expected to. Because all these industries are just going to supply our distillery. Now, when this starts losing money, we can sell it. But for now, we can just keep it as it is. And we made 262,000. Not a massive amount, but it's certainly good enough. And the thing is if we did start a railway, it's kind of like, where would you start? I think, because the thing is the big cities are kind of spread out, like, Vienna, Bratislava, Gior, Budapest, Keksemet, Pex, Zagreb, Varaždin. Yeah, the... fairly big, but they're quite spread out. So it's kind of like, well... And also the terrain is pretty nasty. Let's be honest. Look at it, like... I mean, yeah, the AI took the shortest route, so they're a bit foolish. Because they're using Stirlings, which aren't very good on hills. On a very steep hill, like, rather than go round the hill. But even then, it'd be pretty awful. Because you'd have to build, like, round here, and then round there. And obviously, you're going through trees, which makes it even more expensive. And then round here. And then you want to build a bridge and through more trees, and it's just kind of trees or hills everywhere. It's just not very pleasant. Probably going to want to upgrade that, to be honest. Actually, I could buy some of these. Buy that one. Leader of a Serbian separatist group has come to you looking to make a deal. He asks that you sign a document stating that you feel the treatment of Serbia by the Emperor of the Austrian-Hungarian Empire is biased and unfair. Such a statement by a person of your influence will have a notable effect on the Royal Court. However, the details are not finished, so he will return to you at the end of the year to help you, to tell you how he can help you if you decide to help Serbia. I'll tell you now, he makes access to Serbia cheaper at the cost of making access to everywhere else more expensive. I think we're just going to go ahead and buy access to Russia now. Now, I think it works out that the amount you save by Serbia being cheaper doesn't make up for the fact that everywhere else becomes more expensive. So, even if Serbia became 1 million instead of 3 million, you'd save 2 million, but everywhere else gets proportionally more expensive, i.e. gets more expensive by the same percentage, such that it actually becomes more expensive, even if you take, like, the easiest path, which, admittedly, if you're just looking at access rights, would be kind of Bosnia-Herzegovina, also an empire. You have to buy anything off an empire. Problem with that, of course, is a lot of mountains, a lot of trees, which is why I prefer Romania, Bulgaria, Ottoman Empire, and then you kind of come in round here, and then you can make quite a lot of money in Romania because of Bucharest and Constanta. And then you could, in theory, go off into Russia. Were we building a normal railroad, if you have a... Yeah, there you go. Serbia gets reduced by 50%, everywhere else gets increased by 30%. No, we're not going to do it. Because you'd save 1 million by getting cheaper into Serbia, but you'd have to pay... I think it'd be 4 million more everywhere else. So overall, unless you're just going to exploit the fuck out of Serbia, and Serbia doesn't really have a lot, like, the only real good thing in Serbia is Belgrade, economy-wise. So it's kind of just, like, not really worth it. AI not doing so good. And this is why we aren't building trains. You just don't make any money. You just don't make any money if you build the trains. Could look into other industries. So, wool. Could look at buying that. It's a bit expensive for what it is. Yeah, it's a bit expensive for what it is. If only I'd have built one myself. Because there's a ton of wool coming in. So, how much actually is a textile mill? 870. I'm gonna do it. That's an expensive loan. I think there's enough wool that it should make a profit. Where's the cotton? Yeah, they're only somewhat pleased with us. It is in a recession, so we do make less money. There's barely any cotton in the map, that's a bit annoying. There's a cotton farm there, but that's all the way in Russia. Of course, this is the Russian Empire, so it's not actually Russia anymore. Chisinau, pronunciation, capital of Moldova, Romania boundary isn't like that, in present terms. Ottoman Empire obviously doesn't exist anymore. Bulgaria is different, possibly a bit bigger, maybe more square. I don't know, because it's kind of rectangular there. If that makes any sense. And also, obviously, I mean, like, because Ottoman Empire exists, Macedonia, Albania, and Greece aren't countries in this game, because they're all owned by the Ottoman Empire. I say owned, I mean ruled. Ruled over, but you know what I mean. I'm not actually sure when Greece gained independence from the Ottoman Empire. I think it was 1857, so maybe Greece is a country in this precise moment. Stock split 2-for-1. That's nice. So we are making profit, just not a massive amount. But we do have a lot of time. Because the thing is all we have to do... I say all, it's not easy. Buy access rights to everywhere, which, like I said, will cost 9 million. Thanks to the fact that it's now been made. No, actually, it's not more expensive. I got confused for a second. Yeah, so we need 9 million to get everywhere. We are going to want to buy Romania eventually, because then we can start buying industries in Romania. And then once we've done all that, we want to obviously connect Vienna to Istanbul. But that'll be like the last thing we do. I mean, we're also going to want to look at our net worth, of course. Could upgrade this. Could also buy one of these. How's the textile mill doing? Very nice. So yeah, we want to upgrade that. Still not sure whether we upgrade this distillery or not. I think, yeah, we should actually. So this guy has actually been fired from his company because he's doing so poorly. Economics back to normal because we were in a recession. And we made 417,000 that year. We're going to want to upgrade that. Because it's reached capacity. But now that we've upgraded this textile mill, it should be doing really well. And we've got growing prosperity. This guy's actually making a tiny profit. I'm wondering if my textile mill's made any difference to his company, because he's now got more stuff to haul. He's only making... That's the thing, like, he's only making $10, or $14, hauling clothes, and that's like the primary finished good. Well, that and alcohol. He'd make money if he could ship it out, but he can't, because he doesn't have the money. It is very difficult to make money in this game, in this map, for some reason. Unless you go industry. The economy is just weak and it doesn't really improve. Obviously, I also want to look at our net worth because we're going to need 15 million. Looks like the stock's going to split again. It's always good. Oh, okay, the stock did not split. But we've got net worth of roughly 500,000, so that's good. Economic boom times ahead. Put in some dividend. Try and boost our net worth. Don't want to buy too much stock on the margin, because I've kind of learnt my lesson. That never really goes well. It's a hyper-aggressive tactic. It can pay off, but it can also lead to financial ruin. And we don't want negative net worth, because then we get margin calls, and if we end up with negative purchasing power, then we can't get positive net worth. And if we can't get positive net worth, there's no way we can get gold. Simple as. The thing is, in this mission, we're either going to get... Realistically, we're either going to get gold, silver, or nothing. Like, there's no way we can get bronze. If we get bronze, we get silver. If we get... And the only thing stopping us from getting gold will be net worth. Because I don't think 30 miles an hour is going to be that difficult. Because all we're going to have to do is buy one train, give it one random express thing. Don't even need a caboose. Put it on the flattest piece of track, get it up to top speed, and just go. And hopefully it'll average 30 miles an hour on that tiny little route. It's very cheating, but it's the easiest way of doing it, and it's not like you've broken the game rules, you've not used any kind of cheat code. It's more kind of exploiting the game than cheating. That said, I've never seen anyone get a gold on hard by not using that method. I've seen people get silver, and I think I've got silver before, but I've never got gold. So, yes, it's exploity, but if it works, it works. Let's buy back some more stock, buy some more shares in ourselves. Probably not going to want to buy stock in the AI because their share prices fluctuate too much and they're probably just going to go down. Now that is interesting. Obviously, 753,000 and being excited is all very good. We are in an economic boom, it's also good. But what is interesting is the fact that even though he got fired for doing a poor performance, they've actually managed to expand by taking out a small loan of $1 million. But if we look at other industry, there's a whole lot of stuff in Broad. Yeah, this lumber mill's making a lot of money. Could build a lumber mill of ourselves for 1 million. Yeah, so the 30% off industries is really going to help. There's iron. We can't get goods from just iron anymore. I think that ends in 1877. So these logs, where do they come from? They come from kind of all over the place. We could build a lumber mill in Zagreb. Or we could build a furniture factory in Zagreb. I think a lumber mill in Zagreb would be quite good. Furniture factory is more expensive. Because there should be enough logs for it to be profitable. Could also build a textile mill. No, we don't want that because we're not building a railway. As harsh as it is, we would have literally no use for it. Because we're only going to want to run one train. I think we're going to build a lumber mill here. Because there are some logs. Should make some money. That's not massively interesting, but I'll have a look at it anyway. There's some grain in Budapest, so these are starting to make some cash. Well, actually, this one was already making cash. This one barely making cash. Could build, like, hotels and stuff, but I often don't because I don't think... They barely make any cash. I mean, they're cheap as fuck to build, 100,000 each. But, I don't know, they don't make a lot of profit. Whoa, there's a lot of lumber here. Why is there so much lumber here? I mean, it's because of this furniture factory, which is making an absolute fortune. So we're going to want to build a furniture factory here. Oh, and he's been fired. So, both the AI have been fired. They're only somewhat pleased with us, even though we did do quite well that year. Yeah, we didn't make as much money as we did the year before. Let's increase the dividend. Oil refinery. Is there actually any oil? Yes, but it's in Russia. No surprise there. Technically it's not Russia, it's Moldova. And I don't know what country that would be. It could be Ukraine. It could just be Moldova. But in this game it's Russia, so I'm just going to call it Russia. Now, we are making good profits. It's to be expected. This lumber mill. Possibly want to upgrade that. Still want to build a furniture factory in Arad, I think it's called. When we get the cash. Yeah, Arad. It's going to want a furniture factory. But we're also going to want to upgrade here. Potentially. Actually, maybe not. No, actually, I think we will. But yeah, we're going to want a furniture factory here because there's an absolute ton of lumber. So we're going to need a bit more. Let's take out another loan, actually. And put a furniture factory. Expensive, but it should. Yeah, it's already making money. Because there's just a ton of lumber. Slow start, but it should hopefully build up. Now the problem is this furniture really wants to go to Vienna because then there's a massive price differential. Or Budapest. Or anywhere really. So these AI companies are going to make money from that. But that's not my problem. I don't really care if they make money. Toy factory. Now that's something we could invest in. Turning lumber into toys, because there is a lot of lumber in Arad. And we can turn it into toys. How much is a toy factory? I think they're quite cheap. Oh. I think they're quite cheap. They're really not. Could take out an 8% loan. It's only 40,000 interest a year, which we could easily afford, so I think we're going to do that and build a toy factory. And it'll make Hungarian toys. And correct me if I'm wrong, but Russian dolls actually originated in Hungary. Hungary? Hungary. So, I've literally just invented the Russian doll in 1893. I don't know when they actually were invented, but yeah. I just invented Russian dolls in Hungary. I don't know why they're called Russian dolls if they come from Hungary. Maybe Hungarian doll doesn't sound as good. or maybe Russian dolls. Maybe Russia changed them or just felt like calling them Russian dolls because they thought, well, it makes Russia look better. And presumably no one disputed it. And anyone who did died. I don't know. Sounds like a Russian kind of thing to do. But anyway, this toy factory might well want to be upgraded. I don't know just yet. At the moment, it doesn't look like it will need upgrading. Textile mill, not doing so good. Lumber mill making an absolute fortune. Furniture factory, gonna want upgrading. Toy factory's doing okay. I don't need to upgrade that. And the distillery is doing absolutely fine. So, let's look at livestock. No. Iron? Yes, there's quite a lot of iron. Pulpwood, so we could build a paper mill. In fact, yes, actually, why did I not do that? If there's logs, that means... If there's a lumber mill, that means there's logs. And if there's logs, that means there's also pulpwood. So yes, we want to build a paper mill. Growing prosperity, that is very good. Lots of iron and lots of lumber. And I think that means that we can build a weapons factory. Ah, they need steel. Yeah, that's not going to work. I can't upgrade it. Now I can. Yeah, so now the money's really starting to pile in. We have used 15 years. But we've still got 20 left. Or 19 left. Probably going to want to buy access rights to Romania when we can. Increase the dividend up a bit. Because the net worth is going up and up and up. Doesn't affect us, but good to know. Admittedly, we are in an economic prosperity, so it is easier to make money. But we aren't using on-margin stock, so I am playing it safe. And dividends pay money to my character, which increases my net worth. Also means I can buy more shares in our own company, which then increases the share price. And it's basically money, 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 money. But you've seen this all before, because I've explained this in my previous videos. I don't know why I'm looking at my train list or my station list, because obviously they're empty, we don't have any. Not really a whole lot to do, because it's kind of just wait for the money to come in. So this paper mill's doing good. Could upgrade. Not just yet. In fact, yeah. Tool and die's not making any money because there's no steel. But there is a lot of cheap iron, and coal's pretty expensive, but could build a steel mill if there isn't one nearby already. See, there is a steel mill in Belgrade. It's making a lot of money. The coal... A lot of coal in Budapest, because there's an electric plant. Something's just disappeared then, I don't know what that was. First Olympic Games to be held in Athens. The first in... Two and a half thousand years, not the first, but first Olympic Games as we know it. that might be recognisable to people in present day. And it's only fair that it was held in Athens in 1896. And every 4 years since, apart from, I think, 1940, 1944, and possibly 1948, the one held in 1936 in Berlin, which is very controversial, obviously, because Hitler. I don't know if they did one in 1948, or if they just kind of... I don't know. But yes, every 4 years, obviously. I feel like we've seen that figure before, so I think we possibly made that much... I don't know. I was thinking we made the exact same figure 2 years in a row, but we didn't. Just very similar figures. Back to economic boom from economic prosperity. Yeah, the AI really aren't... Well, actually, no, he's doing okay. Interestingly, the Budapest is actually now doing better than the Zagreb line. The Zagreb line has actually connected down over to here. But neither's really doing very well. Got a ton of money. So let's buy into Romania. Let's look at milk. Not a whole lot. What about logs? There's a lot of stuff in Bucharest, but I don't know what it is. Coal. Lots and lots of coal. Just a shame we can't really build anything that demands coal, other than like an electric plant, but they rarely, if ever, make money. As my France game demonstrated. Stock split 2-for-1, that's fantastic. So the net worth is just going up and up and up. I don't think we're going to have any problem with 15 million. Rate we're going. But what do we do? Economic boom fading. That's fine. How are our industries doing? So the toy factory actually made a loss last year. Oh dear. Yeah, I think we'll sell that before it spirals out of control. There's not that much... No, there's not that much lumber anymore. It's all been turned into furniture anyway. So... Produce. Aha! That's my distillery. That's doing well. Not as well as it should be doing. It is pretty old, and it's probably lost a lot of its business, so there's not really much point buying that. That's not making any money. Neither's that. Just look for something to make money with. Aha. A bit of grain, so I could build a brewery. Why did we not make that much? Ah, I know why. Because we sold an industry. We sold the toy factory, which counts as negative industry profit, so we made like minus a million. That's why they're not happy with us. That's not making much anymore. That's a bit worrying. Fine. Right, I do think we'd need another industry of sorts. But I'm not sure as to what.
Um
crap ton of lumber, so I could build a furniture factory. Because there isn't one in Zagreb already. So yeah, let's build a furniture factory. Should be fine. Because that'll increase the demand for lumber. Slow, but hopefully turn the lumber into furniture. A lot of logs. So, could build another lumber mill, maybe. But then I don't want to eat into the sales of this one. So I'm not sure. It is being fully supplied, so... Yeah, that's just dirt. Yeah, that's fine. Two lumber mills. Give me all your logs. Which will then turn the logs into lumber, which will then turn it into furniture, which will then kind of just go all over the place. It is making money, just very slowly. That doesn't affect me. No railroads, no trains. Speeding up a bit. That's not making any cash. Maybe that was a mistake. That's interesting, because it is serviced by the station. It's picking up some, but not a lot, so maybe it was a mistake. That's doing fine. That's doing really good, actually. So I could upgrade that. Very, very, very slowly. I think that was a mistake. How are the others doing, actually? Fine, fine. Yeah, it's just that one. Seems a bit dodgy. But they're pleased with us, and we're making good cash. I just realised that we should have bought 5,000 at the same time. I did that stupid. Bought 1,000 at a time. Did that stupidly. Oh well. It's not that big a deal. Actually, my net worth has massively decreased. I swear it was over 4 million last time I checked. So we're going to want to increase the dividend. $5.31 a share. Gives me like 300, well, close to 400,000. We own about a quarter of the company. So it's like 350,000 per year. Which means we can buy more shares. Which increases my net worth. Everything works out. Ah no, it's doing okay now. I don't want to upgrade it yet. Interesting. That oil refinery is not making any money. Meat plants, not worth it. Everything going well there. That's fine. Don't want to upgrade that. Could build another paper mill, but then after the disaster of the logs, the logs into the lumber. I don't think that's a good idea. No, I think really I could build a steel mill. But it's expensive. I don't know. It could be really good, it could not. Screw it, I've done it. Because there's coal, and there's iron. They've reduced my dividend. That's okay. Because it's still pretty high. It's not going. Steel's expensive here. It's expensive everywhere, to be fair. Oh god, I hope that makes money. I hope I haven't just spent 1.9 million on a steel mill that's not going to make any money. Tire factory? There's no rubber. Where's rubber? Comes from these ports. That's interesting. So I could build a tire factory just directly there. Gonna do that. But I don't know if anywhere actually demands tires. No, they don't. But it might actually make a bit of cash. It's not exactly like, because I mean the thing is it buys the rubber there and it demands, because that tire factory demands rubber, it's going to create a higher price for rubber. But it doesn't have anywhere to sell the tires to. Because nowhere demands any tires. So it's going to make tyres, but it doesn't have anywhere to sell them to. So maybe it's not going to make any money. Unless... Maybe that was a mistake. How is... Shit, hang on, what do we buy? Oh! Nice. That was it, the steel mill. Yes. Didn't do well the first 2 years, but now it's actually kicked into life, it's doing stuff. And electric trains are available. Makes no difference to me. Because we are going to run a steam train. Actually, I guess we might run an electric train. We're only going to want to run one train. It doesn't even have to go from Vienna to Istanbul. We're going to run it from, like... probably there to Bucharest. Nice, long, flat track. Increase the dividend back up. Can't increase it anymore. Could possibly pay that off, but there's not really much point. Because it's due 1913 and the game ends in 1914, so... Definitely no point paying those off, because they end after the game ends. Holy crap, we made 3 million. Yeah, we're doing well. The tire factories aren't doing well. That lumber mill... It's not doing well, so we want to sell that. Tire factory... It was a nice idea, but... It's not going to work, because it doesn't have any... I thought because... Because it can buy cheap rubber... It's going to make tyres. I didn't realise that because it doesn't have anywhere to sell the tyres to... It's not going to make any money. So, that's just going to lose money, 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 and it's going to disappear. Not that it's a problem. There's a $400,000 bonus for connecting there, but we're never going to connect there because we have no reason to. And even if we did, it's very difficult to get there because you have to go through this huge amount of mountains. It's just not nice. Zagreb's become a powerhouse. It's a 5-star city. Compare that to Vienna, which is 3, and Budapest is 4.5. Holy shit. I don't know why, because there aren't really I mean, there's a lot of industries, yeah, but... Ooh, hang on, that's good. Let's buy and upgrade that. Because we've got a ton of money. We just keep making money. Personal net worth is going through the roof. I mean, yeah, we're in a boom, but... Holy crap. Oh, hello. This guy actually managed to create another company. Don't know when he did that, but... Cosice Western. Probably mispronounced that, but... A lot of toys. Where are they being made? Fertilizer factory and a chemical plant? Interesting. But there's no steel, so that's not going to work. The only steel is here, which is demanded here, which is actually now making money, so... I should have bought that ages ago, because I should have realised, oh yeah, steel, demand, money. And we're going to want to upgrade that. So everything is going good. I do prefer games when you actually run trains and have a railroad, but you make so much money from industry. And the fact that it's not like you have to haul a certain number of goods or connect to a certain number of cities. What I am going to do is save the game. Whoops. I think my hotkey's activated because I wasn't actually typing into the thing, so... I know N brings up newspaper, I'm guessing O must bring up the ledger. I'll try it now. Nope. N brings up newspaper. I brings up income statements. E doesn't do anything. T doesn't do anything. X doesn't do anything. P doesn't do anything. And S brings up stations. Okay, so... Yeah. The thing is when I pressed the I wasn't typing, so it brought an income statement. That is interesting. Anyway, I did save the game, but I'm just going to save it again. That's fine. They're really crashing and burning. Although they had a bit of an increase there. They've gone down again. Not quite sure what happened there. In fact, oh shit, I just realised... I need to hurry up, because whilst I've been biding my time, we only have a few years left to actually win this. We still need 5 million to actually get there, and then quite a lot of money just to actually build the damn track. And we still need 15 million in net worth. So yes, we do need to possibly get a move on. I've kind of not wasting time, but biding time. That's not doing great, but it's still making money. That's doing okay. Yeah, they're all doing fine. But we are going to want 5 million. So, going to want to buy into there as soon as possible. I think we can use AI track, but I don't think we're going to need to. Actually, yes, but we are going to use AI track, because we're going to do Vienna... Oh, crap. Vienna, Gyor, Budapest. And then use the AI track to get to here, and then kind of just, yeah. Pretty sure you can use AI track. And the thing is we only actually have to run one train. You're highly annoyed with me. We are in an economic depression. It is going to be difficult to make money. I'm sorry that you're annoyed with me. That's massively frustrating because that's going to impact my share price, which is going to impact my net worth. I hope we're going to do it. Could take out a loan. Really need a million more. I think we can do this. I don't know how much it's going to cost to actually build the track. But we could just take out a big loan, to be fair. Just keep buying... buying shares. Thing is, once we get out of the economic depression, that's just going to shoot up. And because we are in an economic depression, shares are cheap as fuck, so we can just keep buying them. We're not making any money. Steel mill's not doing so good. It's not getting the coal and iron. That's weird. Has it got competition? Or is there just not enough coal and iron? Not enough coal? That's a problem. At least the net worth's going up. So I think we're just going to take out a big loan. We are in an economic depression. Ah, the share price took a hit. Or rather, my net worth took a hit. Aluminium mine. Doesn't impact me. Wow. Constanza's a 4-star town. 4.5-star. Doesn't really have a lot of profitable industries, which is interesting. That's actually good, because that means that Zagreb town itself will stop eating up all my coal. So more of it can be turned into steel. New train available, doesn't make any difference to me. What I really want is to get out this depression. Oh jeez. All my industries are profitable, so I don't want to sell anything. Could just take out a big loan. If I took out an 8 million loan, we have 12 million, that might be enough. But we still need the net worth. So I don't want to do it just yet. What I will do is buy the access rights though. Yeah, so they've reduced the dividend. But now we just have to build the stations and the track. And we're only going to want 4 stations. Vienna, Istanbul, Bucharest, and Craiova. But we've only got 3 years left, and we're really not doing well. Oh god, what the hell? Share price is collapsing. This is awful. Share price is collapsing. I really need to get out of this depression. Might have to take out a massive loan. If we were in an economic boom, the share price would be double at least what it is, and we'd probably have 15 million in net worth. But we're just not doing well. They're doing well. That's interesting. And they're doing well. Can't get out the depression. The problem is it's random as well. It's not like I can be like, oh, the depression will end after a certain number of years. It's just gonna go on. And there's not really anything I can do. Obviously it will end. It's just a case of, will it end in time? Because it doesn't exactly give me long left. That's really gone quick. Yeah, so if okay guys, sorry about that. I really don't know what happened. Basically the game crashed, and it seems to have lost like 10 minutes of video. For whatever reason, it seemed to have cut off the video like 5-10 minutes before. Also, I apologised and I said that I thought the video was like 2 hours long, but I checked the length and it's not as long as... it's like an hour less than I thought it was. Got confused over when I started. So yeah, you didn't miss much. Basically, what happened... trying to remember exactly what got cut off and what didn't when I checked it. Basically what happened was, the game ends January 1914, as I already knew. But the thing is I have to wait until January 1914 because this updates every year. So I can't just have a net worth of 15 million in December 1913 and then be like, boom, gold. I've got to actually wait for January 1913. Why is 1914? Why that's an issue is because my method of increasing my net worth by just artificially buying up all the stock and then inevitably the stock price falls and I have a broker call. January 1914, the reason is because the net worth goes up when you buy all the stock, obviously, and then it rapidly goes down. That's why you have the margin call. So I've somehow got to find a way of getting to 15 million net worth and keeping it over January 1914. Which is a lot easier said than done. Because the problem is if I don't buy stock on margin, I don't think I can get to 15 million, because I would need an extra 6 million in, well, a year, 11 months, call it 10, because that's not going to happen. So it's going to be very difficult. Basically, I got silver both times because of my net worth. My average train speed, as a matter of fact, was like 50 miles an hour. because I just ran one train on very flat track with one load of passengers. So yeah, that was not an issue. So the train speed isn't an issue. What is an issue is the net worth, of which I don't really know what to do about that. So I may have to settle for silver, which is very depressing. But yeah, that's all I really want to say. Just very wary, because I don't want to wake people up. Because it is currently 2:30 in the morning. Just goes to show what kind of time I started this recording. I started this recording at like 1 a.m. Admittedly, that was stupid, but I thought I could get away with it without waking people up, and it doesn't sound like I've woken anyone up yet, so... Yeah. We are in an economic recession. That depression really fucked me over. Probably should have also been more aggressive with the stock market earlier on and maybe bought more shares and more on margin. But anyway, let's build this track. Excuse me. I did build a station in Bucharest and I did build a station in Constanta. I built large in both, which is a bit unnecessary, but I just wanted to make sure that I'd actually get the passengers. Actually, one thing I could do is just run a freight train between Constanta and Bucharest. Nothing's stopping me doing that, because if it makes a profit, then good. And it doesn't impact my express speed. So that should be perfectly fine. But what we want to do now is get to Istanbul. What the hell is that, stupid mouse? And yeah, the track to Istanbul is expensive because of the terrain, so I'm glad I took out all those loans, although it will eat in my profit this year. Small station for Istanbul, we don't run any trains there, so we don't care. Right. So this just goes really fast. Economy back on track. Averaged 47 miles an hour. Right, what we're going to do now is just any freight and put on a caboose. And if that makes some profit, then good. Making a lot of profit, actually. Just hauling a load of alcohol. It's not going to impact our express speed, so it's just going to give us a bit more profit. Let's just buy a load of shit on the margin. Buy back a load of stock. Now, just keep this above 15 million, and we'll be fine. Oh shit, I need maintenance and service, because this is actually running as a train now. So as long as that's above 15 million, we'll be okay. but I'm very scared that share price fluctuations will mean that I fail. Ah! See, this is exactly what happened last time. The share price just goes down to, like, such a point that I can only get silver because my net worth seems intent on staying about 11 million. Great. So, try again. I am aware that I'm reloading, which some may consider cheating, but... I am very persistent. I don't want silver, I want gold. Apologies, I was taking a drink. Right, I really don't know how I can keep this share price as high as physically possible. I can't take out a loan to give myself more money. So unless I just buy... Because it's fine now, but... It won't be at the turn of the year. Like, it's fine now. Won't be year's end. Oh, fuck off! It's 15 million! How utterly ridiculous is that? Literally 1,000 more and I would have got gold. Right. Not gonna give up. I mean, it's fine now. If I just do nothing, what would happen? It goes down. Can I not win? Can I literally not win? Is there no way I can win? Ooh! Oh, this is gonna be sneaky as fuck. Actually, it might decrease... If I sell the industries, that would give me a crap load of money, but it might decrease my share price. Ooh, I don't know. Well, I guess, I mean, I've saved the game at, like, the latest possible moment, so... I guess it's worth a shot. Now, has my share price decreased? It hasn't at the moment. So I'm just selling everything I own. Absolutely everything must go. Then buy all the shares. And... What the hell happened to my net worth? Oh god, the share price absolutely plummeted. Okay, selling the factories didn't seem to work. The share price plummeted, and I'm now bankrupt. Didn't think it would work. What about buying share prices in the AI? Might that work? Come on, surely that's so high I can't lose. How the fuck? What stopped me? Okay, this game is broken. This game is broken because my net worth is fine. My net worth is fine. My train speed is fine. My train speed is definitely fine because it's above 20. It's saying it's 51, and it's got to be above 20 to get the silver, so my train speed must be fine. So, the only thing it would have a complaint over is my net worth. So why is it still giving me silver? I have literally no idea on that matter. But what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to accept defeat, to be honest. Because I literally have no idea. I thought that method would work. As it stands, I literally have no idea. I don't have a clue. As far as I'm concerned, I got gold. But the game wants to give me a silver. So, I don't know. But anyway, that is the... that's a really disappointing ending. But that is the Orient Express on hard, with a silver or a gold, depending on what you believe. I mean, there are arguments both ways. As far as I'm concerned, I got gold, because my net worth did go over 15 million, and I did technically do everything for gold. Yeah, I had to reload the game a few times. So, silver or gold. Game wants to give me a silver. Personally, I think that's a gold. It's dodgy tactics either way, so... But anyway, that's the end of this video. That wasn't the Orient Express. I did play it on hard. Gold did technically elude me. But I hope you've enjoyed this video. Leave a like, share, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Whatever that may be. And take care, and goodbye, folks. Bye.